a prelude to a full-blown digital martial law. That's how human rights group Karapatan describes the order of the Philippine government to block several websites with alleged links to communists. It says the move affirms concerns raised by several groups against the anti-terrorism law are legitimate. Karapatan also calls the order a blatant violation of constitutional and international human rights standards. The National Telecommunications Commission, or NTC, earlier blocked several websites for their alleged links to rebels. They include sites of media outlets and progressive groups. The move was done upon the request of National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon.
For former Supreme Court spokesperson and criminal law professor Theodore Te, the NTC order may be considered a form of prior restraint when it comes to news providers and a violation of freedom of expression. But Esperon insists there's no violation of press freedom whatsoever.
There will always be our own concern for press freedom because that is something that is dear to us. But there is also our responsibility for correct information and our aversion for misinformation. Okay lang yung criticism, pero they connect that to towards recruitment of people that may join the armed group, which is the NPA. Iba na ang takbo.
Retired Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Capio, one of the petitioners who questioned the anti-terrorism law before the High Court, also speaking out against the move. He says most organizations included in Secretary Esperon's list were not even designated as terrorists by the Anti-Terrorism Council.
The ATC, the Anti-Terrorism Council, did not recommend anything against these websites, no? Mm. Wala. Ito, galing lang ito sa National Security Council. Pinadala ng letter yung NTC na i-block itong mga websites na ito. So, actually, it's just the action of National Security Council and the NTC. So, yun ang ablahin ngayon ng mga website na anong kasalanan namin? Wala naman kayong court order at saka wala kayong power to block the website.
For Senator Panfilo Lacson, the blocking of the websites is justified if they are being used to finance the Communist Party of the Philippines, which has been labeled as a terrorist group by the government. Lacson is one of the principal sponsors of the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020. The security contingent for the inauguration of Philippine President-elect Bongbong Marcos swells to over 16,000. These will include personnel from the Metro Manila Police Department, the Philippine Coast Guard, the Fire Protection Bureau, and other law enforcement agencies. A week before his June 30th inauguration, Marcos visited Bacoor City in Cavite Province. Cavite delivered more than 1 million votes for Marcos in the May 9 polls. He appealed to Filipinos for their cooperation as he prepares to take on the challenge of lifting the country out of pandemic-induced losses.
Tulungan niyo po ako. Mahirap po ang ating kailangan gawin. Marami po ang ating kailangan gawin. Ngunit sa tulong ninyo, sa pagkakaisa ninyo, sa ating pangarap na pagandahin ulit ang buhay ng Pilipino. Itong ating pangarap na maging mas maayos, mas mapayapa at mas maganda ang ating buhay ay magiging totoo kapag tayo ay nagkaisa.
Veteran Airline Executive Jaime Bautista is named Philippine Transportation Secretary of the incoming Marcos administration. The certified public accountant was president of Philippine Airlines for 13 years before he took his second retirement in 2019. Also appointed to the Transportation Department, Cesar Chavez, the former deputy administrator of the Light Rail Transit Authority, will now serve as Transport Undersecretary for Rails. Other new appointees announced Thursday were journalist and lawyer Cheloy Garafil, who will chair the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, and businessman Christopher Pastrana, who will sit as general manager of the Philippine Ports Authority.